Financial Planner Flowbot on YouTube.
Deja vu, we are seeing the same signs now as we saw back in 2008. Let's get into the economic collapse financial news. Now, we are starting to see a lot of the same exact signs that we saw in prior recessions where the economy looked like it was doing very well and the whole thing just completely fell apart. Now, we know the initial jobless claims. They have been falling and falling, declining, 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 and they're trying to convince us that, hey, everyone has a job, no one's applying for any type of jobless claims, everything is perfect. Now, if we look back in time, and we go back to 2007 to 2008, we go back to 2000 to 2001, and we go back to each and every one of the recessions, we see that there's a pattern. There's a pattern where the initial jobless claims, they've reached all-time lows, and then all of a sudden people start to apply. Well, we can see right now that we are back into the 1970 area where initial jobless claims have dropped that far. Now, this is because of all the manipulation that's been going on. And what we're seeing right now is that there are people now applying. In fact, there are over 4% more people on initial jobless claims than this time last year. And the question is, because we've seen this before, is the job market turning? Because every time when we see claims turn, a recession follows. And we're starting to see a lot of very similar signs that we've seen back in other recessions. Here's another sign that we're seeing. Consumers right now are both confident and broke. Now, the last time this happened, guess what? We entered a recession. Now, when we look back in the past, we can see when there are good times, and they last for a very, very long time, which right now people have been thinking and they don't remember the past, they only remember the last couple of years, that everything is great in this economy because we've been brainwashed to believe this over and over. The corporate media continually tells us everything's great, we're in a recovery, this is what a recovery looks like, this is what happens when there is a recovery. The stock market goes up and people lose their jobs. And what happens is that people, well, they start behaving in a way where they don't really care that much anymore. They stop saving. They spend a little bit more. And for those people who've lost their jobs, this doesn't happen at all. And they become confident, but they have no money. We're starting to see this right now. It's the same thing that is happening. And when we look at this, we can see that this happened prior to 2001. It happened prior to 2008. And we are seeing this happen once again. And this time, it is worse than it was in 2006 and is nearly as bad as in 1999. So this is the second sign right now that we are headed for some trouble. Now, if we go back to all the other reports, we can see that there are other signs where the federal government is not receiving the same tax receipts as they once received, because a lot more people have part-time jobs, a lot of people have been losing their jobs, and of course the unemployment numbers have been manipulated, and this shows up in the tax receipts. The corporate tax receipts, revenue coming into corporations, not happening. We're seeing many other indicators showing us that we are already in a recession. We see retail imploding, housing declining. The GDP numbers, how could they be real if 70% is made up of people purchasing things and retail is dying? It makes no sense. We see manufacturing is declining. The Philly Fed right now, well, it looks like it is declining. Now, of course, the hope gauge is saying that, God, we hope things get better. The outlook in 6 months looks great, but the real hard data, it is declining. The Fed is out there telling us, no, there's no inflation whatsoever. You don't have to worry about that. We got it covered. It's very, very low. We're trying to bring it up. But this is a lie. There is a huge amount of inflation. And if you look over the past couple of years, you can see how food prices have gone up. College tuition has gone up. Housing prices have gone up. Automobiles have gone up. If you look, you can actually see it. A lot of this inflation has been put into the stock market and many other areas. And what we're seeing right now is that inflation is clocking in well above its 2% target. Indeed, the New York Fed, the UIG inflation measure, well, it's showing that we're around 3%. And we know it's much, much higher than that. That's conservative right now. And the reason why we know that inflation is much higher, because we can see other central banks in different countries where they're hoarding gold, where they're purchasing a lot of gold. Russia, China, India, many other countries, they're doing Germany. They are buying gold because they know the inflation rate right now is much higher than is being reported. And they're taking advantage of this very low gold price. And this is what they're doing right now. And we can see right now that the New York Fed, well, it looks like there's other things going on beneath the surface where they're trying to convince everyone that, yeah, inflation's up a little bit, but not much. But we could see that it's much higher than it really is right now. We also see these three ominous signals which appear right before a financial crisis, a recession. Now, we have not seen a leadership reversal, a Hindenburg omen, and a Titanic syndrome signal appear simultaneously since just before the last financial crisis. John Hussman pointed out that we've not seen this sort of threefold sell signal since just before the last financial crisis. And he went on to say that since 2007, we've never seen this before. I mean, it happened before 1999. It happened right before 2008. And now we're seeing it again. The Hindenburg omen. This is a sell signal that occurs when the New York Stock Exchange hits new highs and new lows, each exceed 2.8% of advance plus declines on the same day. On Tuesday, they totaled more than 3%. The Titanic syndrome is a sell signal triggered when the New York Stock Exchange 52-week lows outnumbered 52-week highs within 7 days of an all-time high in equities. Stocks most recently hit a record on November 8th. And we had a change in leadership. We also see the flattening of the yield curve. And this is another signal that we are heading towards a recession. Now, I believe the recession already started in 2016. Now, again, what happens is that when we enter a recession or a depression, months later, the Fed, the U.S. government, they go back in time and they say, oh yeah, by the way, it started in 2016. But they don't tell you this at the time it's actually happening. Actually, what they're doing is they're covering it up completely. And if the yield curve inverts, well, we are in a huge amount of trouble. So what we're seeing here is a lot of signals letting us know that something is coming down the road here. And we've been tracking a lot of this information. This is not just made up. It's not something that we haven't seen before. We've seen all of these things happen before. It is a pattern. Now, I know the Fed, they can manipulate, the U.S. government can manipulate the statistics. They can make us believe that everything is fine. They've done this before. They did it back in 2008. Hey, the subprime securities, the AAA, don't you believe it? Everything's contained, don't you believe it? What happens when people stop believing? This is what we're going to see happen. Once we go through this holiday season and retail is a complete and utter disaster, people are going to start scratching their heads saying, okay, what is going on here? They're telling us we're at full employment. I mean, we're at 4.1% here. They're telling us that everything is great, that everything's moving on to online. Why are all these individuals out of work? Why isn't online growing like they said it is? Why are the restaurants closing down? Why isn't there traffic? Why aren't houses selling? This makes no sense whatsoever. Why are the prices falling if everything is fantastic? If all of this is happening right now, how are the GDP numbers above 2%? It makes no sense. Why are the initial jobless claims? Why are people applying for them? Why is that going up? How come the tax receipts coming into the government, well, how come they're declining? When you start to put all these things together and you start to use common sense, you can see why all of what they've been telling us doesn't make any sense. It doesn't matter what the stock market's doing. I mean, they're down there pushing buttons, using their algorithms to keep everything up. I mean, we know the central banks have been purchasing a lot of the tech stocks to keep the system alive. We know that the stimulus rotates between central banks. The ECB does it, then the Fed does it, the Bank of Japan does it, and they keep doing this to keep us all confused on what's really going on. And we can see right now that all of these signs, all of these signals, they're all pointing to the same thing. A recession, a collapse of the system. And we know once we get word that we are in a recession, or people start to wake up and things all of a sudden start to decline, and people look at the stock market and that's declining and everything starts to implode, it's just going to accelerate at that point. And then people, once this happens, the people are going to realize, wow, this is just one gigantic illusion. It's all fake. And you know what happens when things are completely fake? Look what happened to Enron. Look what happened to Bernie Madoff. Look what happened with the last economy back in 2008. When people learn that this is fake, it comes down hard and fast. And this time, it is so fake, it's so not real, it's going to be a complete and utter disaster. That is where we are headed right now.